if this question is posed to us, what according to you is a MOOC, or what according to you are the components of the MOOC? What will each of us say?
So what was the need for calling it a MOOC or making it into a MOOC? Online courses existed for a long time, good courses, open courseware of MIT, you know, but why MOOC?
So one is, I think, the synchronous orchestration,
right?
So the MOOCs have, there is a start date, and the online courseware was not having that model. It was that's just resources.
It
was moving from the model of just having resources to the model of a course.
Unless you look at universities which ran online courses as part of their formal courses. There was a start date, there was an end date, there were these participants.
Yeah.
At the moment, this concept of having technology to support big data, that's when I think really MOOCs really play. I mean, that's when MOOCs originated for me.
So you're looking at a historical perspective.
I think I'm looking at it more from a technology perspective.
But I'm saying, so what he said was the pedagogy perspective, that instead of just self-paced, that you, it's a resource, you use it whenever you want to. Instead of that, it has been formally given out as a course where there is, the structure is defined by the instructor, and only in that manner it should start.
So I think these resources, they were never called a course. No,
yeah,
they were
not
resources.
Courseware.
No, but there were course, like
where?
In your NPTEL.
Or
we had NPTEL courses.
Courseware.
But that course, so from course to a MOOC, so one need, what he just said was that it has to be following a synchronous pattern so that people can interact at the same time. That is definitely one. Anything else?
So the other way, so what has changed in a MOOC is the massive part,
so
and the open part.
Correct.
Because the online courses were for specific.
So are we saying that M and O are attached to that O and C?
Correct.
So O and C existed.
Correct.
Yes. Online. We are just saying it is M.
So open, on the one hand,
open
courseware
also
existed.
Yeah.
Open courseware, but without the structure of a course existed.
Right.
Correct.
On the other hand, formal structured courses existed.
Correct.
But they were not open and they were not online in this.
Yes.
I'm sorry, they were not open and they were not massive in this sense.
So the massive has another role to play. So because of the massive, new technologies also came into play. So if it were an online course, I am still looking at analytics which the university normally provides to me. When, because of the massiveness, I think a big push came towards looking at analytics.
I mean, earlier you had a single university system, it's a server client, whatever be the architecture, so there is a central thing. The moment the idea of cloud came in, and people, so anyone could, you could have your server hosted virtually everywhere. I think that is when, for me, this idea of MOOC as we know now.
So the first question is, what is the goal of the MOOCs, as at least the first generation MOOCs as we know it? And secondly, did the technology come first, or did the goal come first and then the technology
was born
or was invented to realize this goal?
So let me take a shot at answering that. I think what happened, or what the natural progression was, that everybody agreed that the expert lectures by the leaders in the field needs to be disseminated widely.
Okay.
So that's where the
archival value,
and not just archival value, it's a dissemination, like the new form of information dissemination.
Access to the experts.
Yeah, not just through textbooks that are written, but also through videos that they give.
Right.
So initially, a whole bunch of these expert lectures became available, like some of which became the OCW courseware material and so on. And after that, we thought of putting some structure on it and creating courses, at which time activities, assignments, all those things also became part of these OCW materials, right? And subsequently is when people thought that why not make this an open course. At least if you look at the historical evolution, that has been the direction.
The way these Udacity or those things came, it was Andrew's, that machine learning lecture, which he openly put out.
Correct.
And that's when they saw that there is this, I think they just tested the proof of that concept. And they succeeded in that. That's when these platforms, where Coursera or those kind of platforms, the idea of those platforms emerged. So for me, it's all about the technology being available at the right place. the evolution of technology has a larger way. The goal was always there, I think, from 90s or whenever we are thinking of computer-based or technology-based interventions in classrooms or any other places. So having wikis, having all these things put out, blogs. So this idea of dissemination was always there.
Correct.
And the moment this technology came in, that's when, it got a big push. Okay, why don't we do this? Why don't we move out the university from the walls to...
No, and it's become so routine for instructors now that it's yet another format that a regular instructor can play with.
Hmm.
Yeah.